I would like to welcome all of you to St. Andrew's Cathedral as we host the Bicentennial Christmas Carol Service. On behalf of the National Council of Churches of Singapore, the Diocese of Singapore, and the Outreach Society of Singapore. The first part of the service is an abridged version of our traditional Lessons and Carols service. During the second half, we will be hearing the story of Singapore told through music. In this Advent season, we prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels. In heart and mind, go even unto Bethlehem and see the thing which is come to pass, and the babe lying in the manger. Let us read and mark the Holy Scripture and sing carols to the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. We so gather to give thanks for 200 years of his favor and blessings on our nation. Let us make this cathedral and our nation glad with our carols and songs of praise and prayer. This is the place. We now proceed to the second half of the service led by Dr. Peter Loong and the Singapore Combined Church Choir. This is the place.
We welcome you to the second part of tonight's program, where we will tell you the Singapore story with thanksgiving for the many blessings of God upon our nation.
Act 1, Early Beginnings. The influx of many immigrants laid the foundation for a multicultural Singapore. Adiamus is a song with a glass of negative sounds that has no linguistic meaning or message. But when put together, a beautiful symphony of sound is created. Adiamus reflects the seemingly random influx of diverse cultures which make up the nation we know today as Singapore.
Thank you.
The influence of the Christian faith also increased with the arrival of European traders and travellers like the Portuguese, Dutch and British in the 15th century onwards. The new sounds of European carols and chants were added to the native sounds of Singapore. Some Christian leaders and missionaries were involved in pioneering the early educational, medical, and social work. All Things Bright and Beautiful is a traditional English children's hymn that is chosen to reflect the early growth in the work of education in Singapore.
Thank you.
years were years of suffering for many. Pia Jesu, merciful Jesus, grant them rest.
Thank you.
sense of uncertainty. Internally, we were faced with the challenges of the diversity of culture, language, race, and religion. The peaceful and rapid growth of Singapore into a confident nation was unexpected. Is an encouraging message we can bring to an increasingly hostile world. We have been richly blessed by a stable government, which encourages the flourishing of our identity as one nation and one people.
As the Lord surveyed the earth he had made, a tiny emerald isle hid its spine, with little to tell what lay ahead, but right of course, plains and glide. Like the waves that lapped the shores, men came from near and from afar, for tasks of note or simple chores. Some just trade, and some war. Of native princes, legends speak of fleets Iberian and Dutch as well, who came this way to fortunes seek, as on this soil their traces tell. Pioneer fathers, their homesteads left in the glens of the dragon and of the mammoth beast, in search of home for progeny unborn, and saw right here a real new dawn. Then Raffles came with a might of Britannia, emboldened by a vision great in sound. This yet unpolished gem he did claim to enhance the realm of the British crown. With dreams of fortunes to be made, hordes of hopefuls then arrived, all walks of life, all skills and trades. The numbers grew, the city thrived. But soon, the sons of the rising sun surmounted fortress Singapore and rest this gem on the British ground, and then renamed it Jonathan. But forces of freedom soon prevailed as rays of the rising sun receded, but tarnished now was Britannia's claim. The sons of the soil had seen men to the forefront in vibrant white with flag of red and white, sun's blue, crescent and stars hailing vision new for their island home, a future true. And so they toiled 5 decades long, with hearts undaunted and efforts strong, to house, school, and upward move, and cynic's silence, doubters disprove. And so now glistens this ruby bright, warm spirit and vision bright, and glorious strains heard near and far. Madura.
Thank you.
We now welcome Bishop Terry Key, Chairman of the National Council of Churches and Bishop of the Lutheran Church, to give a word.
Our guest of honor, Prime Minister Lee and Madam Wuchi, Minister Josephine Teo and Minister Desmond Lee, leaders and representatives from faith leaders and representatives from the IROO, and especially their President, the Leadership Wong Ping, ambassadors, judges, members of parliament, members of the civil service, bishops, pastors, leaders of the Christian community, brothers and sisters in the Lord. 200 years have passed since the founding of modern Singapore. Today, as we celebrate Christmas and give thanks to God for the giving of Jesus Christ, who with his coming and sacrifice on the cross reconciles us to God, we also take time to reflect and give thanks to God for what he did for us as a nation. Through the British, we have received the English language, the rule of law, the civil administration, and a good educational system. Since our independence, we had an extraordinary founding father, a selfless pioneer generation. We are thankful to God for a strong and stable government with heart that took pains to ensure smooth transition from generation to generation with a good and clear succession plan. Today, we enjoy good and reliable public service, a vigilant defense force, sound economy strategies, and good policies of social justice. We have excellent infrastructures and reliable public utilities that often we take for granted. Safe streets and low crime. Today, as we give thanks to God for Jesus, whose birth we celebrate on Christmas, we also take time to thank Him for all that He did for us as a nation. Today, as we celebrate, let us with thankful hearts commit ourselves to do our part to safeguard all that we have inherited and work together, regardless of race, language, or religion, to strengthen our social cohesion and develop this nation that we all love. Mr. Prime Minister, we thank you for your faithful service to all of us. You serve us for 13 years in armed force, 35 years as minister, of which 15 years as our prime minister. We thank you. And on behalf of the organizers of this special service, the Council of Churches Singapore, the Diocese of Singapore, and our partner, Oxford and Cambridge Society of Singapore, we want to thank each and every one of you for your presence here with us tonight. They make it all the more special. And let us put our hands together to thank you to the three choirs for the inspiring evening. Let us join you. Now we need invite our Prime Minister to say a few words to us. Please.
Bicentennial Christmas Carol service in St. Andrew's Cathedral. I was very moved by the service. It's a beautiful service, beautiful music, beautiful singing. And the message, the story of Christmas and the story of Singapore, how it came to be, what they look back on, what they remember, the joys and the sorrows. We say we celebrate Christmas, but we commemorate the bicentennial. And we say commemorate because 200 years we've been through ups and downs, joys and sorrows, tragedies and successes. And you told some of these in your account of these 200 years in the festival of music, hymns and words, which gave your take on the Singapore Bicentennial. And it's one of the strands, of many strands, which has come together to make Singapore today, 200 years after standard reference. It's what makes Singapore rich, makes our history meaningful, and gives us a sense of purpose to go ahead and do great things for Singapore. So while we commemorate and remember the ups and downs, I think taking these many years and many souls and efforts into account as a whole, we have much to rejoice for. And before Christmas, I think today is a day for rejoicing, for thanking ourselves, thanking the Lord, if you are Christian, and in faith, if you are not, for the good things which have happened to us, for what we have achieved in heaven, and committing ourselves to go forward in harmony and peace and security, which we enjoy in Singapore and a very uncertain world, to make sure that 1500 years from now, a new generation celebrating in St. Andrew's Cathedral, perhaps with a new change of bells pealing, with new revelings, will once again have many reasons to give thanks for the bountiful blessings of the Lord and for the results which we have been able to bring about together. So I wish you all a very Merry Christmas, Christians and non-Christians alike, and a very happy New Year. Thank you very much.
Please remain standing for God's mercy. The Lord God, who has mercifully led our mission Singapore thus far, and who has good purposes for our progress, peace, and impact on the wider world, bless, preserve, and lead us on as one united people. The Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon us and grant us peace.